Hey guys, Drifter here. Welcome to World War II In Depth. In today's episode, we're going to be reviewing the Kar-98 sniper rifle, and you will see a very noticeable improvement in gameplay this episode because it is quite a good sniper rifle. It is quite easy to use, popular for a reason, and I was able to get some very good clips with it. Let's start off today with the damage. The damage is 95, which is a little bit higher than the other sniper rifles in this game, which tend to be 75, 80, something like that. So the base damage on this gun is very, very high, which means it's going to be very good at wall banging, finishing people that are weak, and killing in general. But the base damage isn't really what you're interested in. I know you guys, what you want to know is the one-shot kill areas. Well, it will deal bonus damage if you hit somebody in the head, neck, upper chest, lower chest, or the arms. The lower chest is going to be everything from groin up, the upper chest is pectoral muscles, and in this case it'll count shoulders, bicep, forearm, and hands. So pretty much anywhere except below the waist, like a boxing match, you will get a one-shot kill. One of the things that makes the Kar-98 unique in almost any Call of Duty game is the hit multiplier. When you hit somebody in any of the areas mentioned on the last tile, it'll deal double damage. Most of the time in games like this, it's like 1.1 damage, 1.2 damage. Sniper rifles go a little higher, like 1.5, so that it's easier to wallbang. This is straight up double damage, which is beyond absurd. It means that when you hit somebody there, you'll deal a total damage of 190, almost enough to kill them twice, and enough to kill them four or five times over in hardcore mode, which is just downright crazy, and which also means in hardcore mode, this will wallbang you through just about anything in the entire game. Rate of fire is 51 rounds per minute. Rapid fire only takes it up to around 54 rounds per minute, so not a very big improvement there, though since we're talking about small numbers, you may feel it a little bit more than you would think, but I generally do not recommend rapid fire, and while those numbers may appear slow, they're actually a little bit fast for sniper rifles. Comparatively, the Lee Enfield only shoots at 49 RPM, and the M1903 shoots at a very slow 41 RPM, so this is the fastest of the bolt-action sniper rifles. Another segment that I've needed to add to In Depth after the Sniper Myths episode is one on aim assist. The Kar-98 only has aim assist in the Mountain Division while holding your breath. If you use it in the proper sniping Mountain Division class and do not hold your breath, it won't have any aim assist. So I recommend holding your breath all the time when you're ready to shoot somebody or when you want to snap aim to them. However, there is a caveat. If you decide to use the iron sights, which is a downright filthy, dirty, and hilarious attachment on this gun, you will get auto-aim in, or I should not auto-aim, aim assist is the proper term, in any other class. And before I give you my overall rating on the sniper rifle, I'm going to do a shameless shout-out to myself and my own merchandise. Winter is here, finally, in Texas. Hoodies are in, and I've been selling my own hoodies for about a year now. We've got the new Drifter hoodie, which has the yin-yang zip-up in the front and customizable back, which is free, mind you. The classic blue one that I wear just about everywhere I go, that's just, I don't know, I'm just kind of stuck in that old school kind of thing. I have the Ying Yang shirts, and there's a variety of, well, stranger animal shirts for Ozzy and Boomy. Of note, the merchandise is made in the United States, fair labor, everybody's treated right, the price is as low as possible as I could get and still get decent quality, and it's customizable for free. So whatever the base price is, you can customize it with your name, somebody else's name, or anything you want on the back for free, no additional cost. Custom merchandise, lowest price, and its quality. So now that that shameless pitch for me is out of the way, let's go ahead and talk about the rating on it. This is an excellent sniper rifle in terms of one-shot kill areas. It is the second best in the game at one-shot kill area. The M1903 is a little bit better because it will do groin and the upper legs. However, I do think that the Kar-98 is the overall best sniper rifle for reasons that we're just about to get into, but before that, let's talk about the optics. Some variants do have slightly different optic shapes on the scope, but the default variant is great. I love that the crosshairs are very skinny and thin. It makes it very easy to aim. I tend not to like the other ones with the big obstructive bottoms on them. All I need is thin, equally sized perpendicular lines, and I am happy. The ACOG sight and iron sights are also fantastic for the Kar-98. I had a surprisingly good time hammering people with the ACOG sight, much more than I thought I would with this gun, almost to the point where I thought I was in love until I tried the iron sights. This is the only sniper rifle which you can use the weapon's default iron sights. It comes as an attachment, so it does take up an attachment slot, but it's so fun. It's so rewarding, and it is surprisingly easy to do with the right setup. It really reminds me of Call of Duty World at War, where I would just break the scope off the Ariska and just run around one-shot spotting people, and it's, yes. It's not a good tactic, but it is a very fun tactic. As for why the Kar-98 is so popular if it doesn't have the best one-shot kill areas, well, that comes down to its aim-down sights time and its sprint-out time. The aim-down sights time and sprint-out time are both 350 milliseconds, which is among the faster in the game. Of note, the M1903 does have a slightly faster sprint-out time of 300 milliseconds, but it has a slower aim-down sights time of 400 milliseconds. So overall, when it comes to effective quick scopiness, fast snipiness, most reactive, easiest, best handling sniper rifle, that's going to be the Kar-98. It's also nice that the ADS time and the sprint-out time are identical, so that when you do have your scope up and drawn, you're already good to go and ready to shoot, and it makes the gun feel very smooth, very consistent, and very good. Hip fire is unfortunately very poor. I mean, it is a sniper rifle. We joke about no scopes for a reason, generally wouldn't recommend it, and it shoots so slow that recoil isn't particularly applicable in this discussion. What is applicable is idle sway. Idle sway is about average for sniper rifles. It's neither good nor bad, and if you want to decrease that without using any attachments, you can crouch or prone out. Especially proning out will just about completely remove it. Magazine size is going to be on the smaller side of things, since it is a beefier sniper rifle. Default magazine size is 5, and if you put extended mags on, it goes up to only 7. Ouch. Extended mags aren't really needed, but I run them due to a lack of other choices sometimes, especially if I'm running this off division. A lot of times there aren't other attachments that are that fantastic, so you do see me using them a bit. Reload time is identical to the M1903 in the Lee Enfield at 2.5 seconds or 1.63 with Hustle, which is kind of a mute stat since all of the other sniper rifles have roughly the same performance. So, final thoughts on this gun. It's probably the overall best sniper rifle in the game. Maybe not the best for one-shot kill areas, but it has great handling, which more than makes up for it and makes it a very, very strong competitor to the M1903. The default iron sights are very clear and easy to use, and it feels very good handling-wise. There is a reason this one's used in competitive matches, and the reason this one is used in tons and tons of public matches, and the reason why the other sniper rifles are more niche. I do think the M1903 and both in the Lee Enfield are both kind of underrated, but this one is the best for a reason, and I would recommend using it anytime you want to do some serious sniping. The Kar-98 pairs best with Mountain Division or Infantry Division for a class that we're going to talk about in a little bit, but for the most part, you want to do traditional sniping, you want your aim assist, and you want to stay off the radar, so Mountain is going to be your friend. My recommended setup for public matches is Mountain with either Hunker or Energetic. Those are the two I just gravitate toward the most, and I'm going to use it with Ballistic Calibration and FMJ. As we discussed in the Sniper Myth episode, Ballistic Calibration greatly reduces recoil, and then after that, I don't really need rapid fire, I don't really need extended mag, so I guess I'm just going to go for wall bangs on it. And this gun has more attachments than are really useful because the Ballistic Calibration is just the best one by far. Recommended setup for iron sights, which is also a pretty strong setup for ACOG sight as well, but iron sights is where it's at on this gun. That's what makes it really fun, is I run it with infantry so that I get additional attachment slots, additional ammunition, and I can sidestep with it really fast. Doing a little bit of left stick aiming and sidestepping and being able to line your shots up better makes the gun much, much easier to use. I will run this with Hunker since I don't really need any other perks or trainings for anything, and Hunker just makes me immune to most grenades. The attachments are a little bit different. I'm going to run rapid fire so that my follow-up shots are a little bit quicker, which is going to be super important in close quarters combat, extended mags, and of course ballistic calibration. And yes, before you ask, ballistic calibration does work on the ACOG and iron sights as well, which makes them sway less, which makes them easier to aim with, which allows you to get more one-shot kills. Finally, this gun is also good in competitive. If you're going to snipe in competitive, which is probably going to be in Search and Destroy and going for picks, I'm going to recommend running Mountain along with Hunker. However, you can also run Lookout. I probably wouldn't use this if I were like playing on main stage MLG or whatever, but just doing ranked matches. Lookout will show you some red names in some areas that you probably shouldn't see them, and that can be very critical in Search and Destroy. Attachments would be just the basic scope, ballistic calibration, and FMJ so that you can wall bang people that are hiding. Guys, that's all for this episode of In Depth. I hope that you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something useful. And if you did, don't forget to like, favorite, and subscribe. Drifter out. If you want all the weapon stats for World War II in your pocket to go, then look no further than the Ultimate Utility app by Brass Monkey. It's available on iOS and Android, there are links in the description, or you can just search for it in the App Store.